So good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the final session on differential equations. So in today's session, I am planning to cover up this topic so that next class we can start with vectors in 3D. So in today's session, we are going to primarily cover exact differential equations. We are going to talk about orthogonal trajectories. We are also going to talk about equations of first order and higher degree. And we are also going to take up some application of differential equations in the field of physics, okay, and chemistry also, and maths, of course. Okay, so let us begin with the concept of exact differential equation. So let us start with exact differential equation. Exact differential equation. Okay, as the name itself suggests, these kind of questions are basically of such a type where, let's say you have a function m of xy dx plus a function n of xy. So both are multivariate functions of x and y. And these functions are such that they can be written like an exact differential of some element. Okay, so they can be written as exact differential of, let's say, a function ux comma y equal to 0. That means ux comma y equal to constant becomes the direct solution for this. If you remember, towards the end of the previous class, we actually talked about method of inspection, right, where we learned how to write a particular expression as an exact differential. So that was actually a part of this particular method. So those questions were under the concept of reducible to exact differential equation. So in today's session, we are going to talk on a broader sense that if a differential equation is of this nature, okay, how do you figure out, number one, whether it is an exact differential equation? So first of all, what are the necessary and sufficient conditions? What is the necessary and sufficient condition for any ODE to be an exact differential equation? So how do you identify that it is an exact differential equation? Okay. Second thing, how to find out your ux comma y function. As you can see in the solution, this is your final expression whose differential was given to you in this form. Okay, so basically you are reducing this guy to a differential of a function, and from there you are going to get the final solution. So this is going to be the general solution, correct? So how do you first know whether it is an exact differential equation? Okay, and secondly, how do you find out your u of x comma y? So the necessary and the sufficient condition for any differential equation to be an exact differential equation is if you have been given your function, your differential equation to be of this nature, and you realize that dou m by dou y is equal to dou n by dou x. Okay. If your differential equation satisfies this condition, right? So whatever function is given to you here and here, if this condition is satisfied by these two functions, then it implies that it's a case of an exact differential equation. Okay. So before you proceed, you have to check whether this test is satisfied or not. Now, just a word of advice over here. Please do not use this when you have a format different than this. Are you getting my point here? If your format is different than what is written over here, this condition may not work. So please do not try to apply this to reducible to exact differential equation, which we had done in the last class. Are you getting my point? So this is for those cases where this entire function boils down to just differential of a single function. Okay, so it boils down to this form. It will work only in this case. Are you getting my point here? Okay, so there has been some mistakes done by students in the past where they tried to bring the previous class concept that we had done under this periphery. See, many of them may not satisfy this. Okay, but they are the cases of reducible to exact differential. This is actually a case of exact differential. There's a difference between both the cases. Do not mix them. Okay, I'll give you an example a little later on. But before that, we need to understand why is this condition required. See, this is again a slightly higher level concept. When you say there is a, let's say I call MDX, let's say I drop the word X, Y, I don't want to write too much. Okay, let's say you want to claim that this is differential of some element U. Okay, so M is a function of XY, N is a function of XY, U is also a function of XY. So remember, we had done something when we are learning implicit differentiation that du is actually dou u by dou x into dx, dou u by dou y into dy. Do you recall this? This is how we actually got the formula for our implicit function differentiation. Do you remember, everybody? Okay.
Yes.
If you compare it to this guy, let's compare this with so you're claiming that both these things are same. Okay, that means indirectly you're trying to claim that M is nothing but dou u by dou x. Okay, and N is nothing but dou u by dou y. Okay, now if this is the case, I can say one thing from surety over here, that if I differentiate this again with respect to y, that means I do dou 2u by dou x dou y. It would be same as doing differentiating this partially with respect to x. Okay. Oh, sorry. So this is y over here. This is x over here. Okay. And if you differentiate this with respect to partially with respect to x, this is what I will get with when I do dou m by dou y and when I do dou n by dou x. And you would realize that for any function in x and y, which of course should be differentiable, there is no difference between these two terms. Actually, both are same. This you will learn in your higher grades also in partial derivative. You will realize that this result and this result would be the same results. Okay, so since these two are equal, it implies that dou m by dou y will be equal to dou n by dou x. And that's how this condition comes out, which I had written over here. Okay, so please make a note of this. Now, you'll not find this proof in your regular textbooks. This is something which I am telling you from my higher studies of calculus. Probably you'll learn this in your first year or second year of your engineering. Okay. So this is applicable. I'm again repeating it. This is applicable when you are expecting an exact function differential to come from here. Are you getting my point? Okay. Now, how to find the solution in this case? Okay, let's say this condition is met. Fine. I understood that it is going to be, I realized that it is going to be an exact differential equation. So what is going to be the solution for it? So again, without giving you any proof, the solution for this is given by, okay, so please make a note of this. So the solution of this differential equation is going to be The integral of m function with respect to x, keeping y as constant, plus integral of those terms in n which do not contain x. So you can say terms of the n function. Okay, so remember you will be given this kind of a expression, and you realize that this was a exact differential equation. Then how would you find the solution? By the use of this formula which I am giving you. So m is this function. Integral of this function with respect to x, keeping y as constant. This is important. You have to treat y as constant. Plus integral of those terms of n not containing x. Not containing x. What happened to my spelling? Not containing x. With respect to y, and just put a c on the right side. Okay, so whatever comes out from here, this would be your ux comma y.
So from where did we get this condition?
Actually we got this condition by solving that given set of conditions. Actually I don't want to get into the proof of it, but since you have asked it, see, when you have compared this, your m is actually dou u by dou x, correct? Yes or no?
Yes.
Correct. And your n was dou u by dou y. Correct. So what do we normally say is that if you look at this expression, it is basically trying to say u is integral of m with respect to x, keeping y as a constant. Yes or no? Correct?
Yes.
Keeping y as a constant. And from this condition, you get u as integral of n. Okay. And you'll end up getting such functions which are function, you'll end up getting such expressions which are just completely functions of y. Okay, so if you integrate this, basically you'll end up getting something like this. I'll just write it down over here. So n will become du by dy plus some functions of y. Getting the point? So your m dx plus n dy will become dou u by dou x into dx plus dou u by dou y plus fy dy. Okay. And if you write it properly, it will become dou u by dou x dx plus dou u by dou y dy plus f of y dy. Okay. If you see this very closely, this is actually your du. Okay. And this is nothing but fy dy. Sorry, fy dy. Okay. So in order to get this value, we have to integrate, or you can think as if it is nothing but it is d of u plus integral of fy dy. Okay, so this term, I'm writing it like this. Hope you can realize that the d operator and the I operator will cancel each other out, giving you this kind of an expression. Okay, so this is what is compared to the integral of this term. Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that's why fy means those terms which do not contain an x, like this. Okay. You don't have to go into details of this because it requires your understanding of partial derivative also. So please make a note of this. So two things you need to understand over here is one, how do you identify a differential equation? So if you realize that your differential equation satisfies this condition, okay, then it's a case of an exact differential equation. And secondly, your solution is going to be integral of m dx, where y is treated as a constant, plus integral of those terms in n not containing x. Or you can say not containing x terms in n. Integral with respect to y and just put a constant on the right side. Is it fine?
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, if we have the mdx plus ndy equal to zero type of equation, and dou m by dou y is not equal to dou n by dou x,
could then it is not an exact differential equation.
Sir, but it could be reducible to exact?
It could be reducible to exact, but you cannot directly use this formula that you have discussed over here.
Okay, sir.
What's the point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let's take a few questions on it. Let us first start with this question. Let's take, 1 plus 2xy cos x square minus 2xy dx plus sin x square minus x square dy equal to 0. Okay. Everybody, please try this out. So first thing is, this is your m, this is your n, okay? Just check dou m by dou y and dou n by dou x. Are they giving you the same expression? Let us check. Dou m by dou y means you have to only treat y as a variable, x will be treated like a constant. So this will become 2x cos x square minus 2x, okay? Here, you have to differentiate partially with respect to x. So this is obvious, that will be cos x square into 2x minus 2x. Yes, they are same. They both are same. So the moment you realize both are same, you can directly go with the final formula that we had discussed. Integral of m with respect to x, treating y as a constant. Treating y as a constant plus terms not containing x, okay, dy, and write a c on the other side. Okay, oh, so sorry. Now, terms, m was integral of 1 plus 2xy cos x square minus 2xy dx. Okay, now remember, there is all the terms in n. all the terms in n have an x in them, right? So you have to write a zero over here, okay? Equal to constant. So the other term will not appear at all. Yes, so we need to just integrate this. So this is x. Yes, how would you integrate this? Remember, you have to take x square as a t. So it is something like 2y, or you can say just a y. And you have 2x cos of x square dx integral, okay, equal to a c. Minus 2xy dx, okay? So this is going to be x. This is just like cos t integral. Cos t integral is sine t, so it will be this. And this is going to be minus y x square equal to c. So this is going to be your final answer. Is that clear? Any questions here? Any concerns? Correct. Correct, Param. Okay. Let's take another one. Dy by dx plus y cos x plus sin y plus y by sin x plus x cos y plus x equal to 0. The first attempt should always be whether it is variable separable. If that doesn't work, is it reducible to variable separable? Okay. Homogeneous, you can directly come to see from the expression, that you don't have to even try it out, because looking at the expression itself, you can come to know that whether expression is homogeneous or non-homogeneous. Then try LDE if you feel LDE can be applied. If nothing works, then probably it may be a case of an exact differential equation.
So can they ask this stuff in mains and advanced?
See, they can ask this stuff in advanced, not in mains.
Okay, so.
Yeah, but so in advanced, they can give you. See, the I think you may have seen the paper this year. Did you get a chance to see the paper, advanced paper?
Only physics so far, sir.
Oh, okay. See, maths also. The paper was not very easy, okay. And I felt that the paper were much difficult as compared to what we used to get previous years. One of our very good students, he is just getting 50 in the second paper.
Sir, for n, if there's a term containing both x and y, we still don't consider it, right?
Sorry? Yeah. If there is a term with both x and y, you have to drop that term.
Okay, sir.
For example, if you write this, you will be writing y cos x plus sine y plus y dy, sorry, dx. Plus sine x plus x cos y plus y, sorry, plus x dy equal to 0. Correct. So this is your m and this is your n. So first we'll find dou m by dou y. Dou m by dou y will give you a cos x plus cos y plus a 1. Dou n by dou x dou n by dou x. What happened to my pen? Dou n by dou x. Yeah, this will give you cos x plus cos y plus 1. Yes, both are same. Both are coming out to be the same. Okay. So your solution will be integral of m with respect to x, but treating y as a constant. So this integral, but treating y as a constant. In reality, it is not, but it is just for the process to follow. Okay. Plus integral of those terms here, which are not containing x. So I don't see there is any such term. So you'll have to write zero. Okay. Of course, it will give you some constant, which will club with the constant over here. So you don't have to put, you know, multiple terms. Okay. So this is easy. So this will give you y sine x plus plus. This will give you x sine y plus xy. This is going to be your answer. Is that fine? Any questions here? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Try one more. Y square e to the power x y square plus 4x cube dx plus 2xy e to the power x y square minus 3y square dy. Done. Could you use chain rule in these kind of problems? Yeah, I mean, yeah. See, observation is always there, Ruchir. Observation is a special case, or you can say it is a, I think I should say it's a broader case of these kind of problems. This is actually a no-brainer. When you realize that your dou m by dou y is equal to dou n by dou x, it works even for those cases where observation works. Okay. So observation is a broader way to solve it. And when it fits into the formula, then it actually becomes a no-brainer. Then you can solve it by the use of this formula blindly. Okay. So if you can solve it by observation, nothing like that. I mean, that is the most robust way that you should, you know, apply to solve a question. So method of inspection is a broader method of this particular type. Correct? So it can apply even to those cases which were exact differential equations, but it was not covered under that necessary condition. Try to get me that. Okay, so I want to say inspection is a broader methodology to solve. And within that, there are some functions which will satisfy dou m by dou y is equal to dou n by dou x. Are you getting it? This becomes no-brainer. That means you can solve it without, you know, trying to do anything. But for these problems, yes, you have to apply your inspection method, which is actually reducible to exact differential. So these are the ones which are reducible to exact. Do you get what I want to say?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I think in this case, you would realize that, let's say this is your M, this is your N. Correct? So what was dou M by dou Y? That would be 2y e to the power x y square. Correct?
So we don't differentiate the x y square part here.
Plus y square e to the power x y square. Correct? This will be zero. So I'm applying product rule on this. So this part I differentiated first. This I kept it as it is. And then I differentiated the e to the power x, y square part over here. Oh, sorry.
Wait a minute. What about the y square?
X, y, also. Yeah, sorry.
Wait a minute. What about the y square one?
That's what I did. No, this part I differentiated over here. This term I copied as it is. Then y square I copied as it is. Derivative of e to the power y square will be e to the power x y square into derivative of this with respect to y. So it will be 2xy, no? Okay.
Yes, sir. Got it.
What about dou n by dou x? Dou n by dou x. Okay, same thing. Let's apply over here. So this will become 2y e to the power x y square. Okay. And then it will be 2xy e to the power xy square into y square. So that will give you 2xy cube. So I think this term matches with this and this term matches with this. And 3y square minus 3y square anyways is zero. So yes, both are same. Both will give me the same results. Okay. So when you realize that it is fulfilling your criteria, then it becomes a no-brainer question. So you just have to integrate y square e to the power x y square plus 4x cube dx, treating y as a constant, plus the terms in n which do not have any x, so only minus 3y square is such a term which doesn't have any x dy, and just write a c on the right hand side. Correct? So let us complete this. So this is just like y square e to the power x y square divided by y square. Remember, you have to follow reverse chain rule over here. So this is a constant and this is some constant multiplied to x. So you have to divide by that constant. Correct. This term integration is x to the power 4. Here you'll get minus y cube, and this is equal to c. Y square can be cancelled off. Your final solution would look like this. This is your final solution. Okay. This you can also do with inspection. Again, don't get me wrong. This is not beyond your inspection. Inspection is a much broader way to solve questions. Okay. So these are those few instances within inspection which can be solved by the use of this formula. So if you don't want to apply your brain, that means you check first of all, is it satisfying that exact differential equation scenario? If yes, then you can go ahead with the use of the formula. You don't have to figure out by inspection anymore. Okay, but let's say you don't want to use a formula, you want to go by inspection, then you can go for the inspection. Are you getting my point here, what I'm trying to say? Okay, let's try this question. X square dy minus y square dx plus xy square x minus y dy is equal to zero. So if you see, you have just minus y square dx as your, minus y square is your m, and rest of the term, that is x square, xy square, x minus y is your n term. Okay. Yes or no? Now, if you do dou m by dou y, you'll end up getting minus 2y. And if you do dou n by dou x, what do you get? You get 2x, you get 2xy square, and you get minus y cube. They don't match. They are not the same. Correct? Right? So in this case, it is reducible to exact differential. You cannot solve it by the use of the formula. Okay, so how will I solve this? If you remember, this is the question that I had taken with you last class. If you just turn back to the notes of the last class, you'll realize that this question I had done in the class. Do you recall, or should I do it again? Okay, so basically what I want to explain through this question is that here, the formula will not work. The formula fails here. Okay, because this condition is not met. So you cannot solve it, even though it is reducible to exact differential. Okay, you cannot solve it by the formula, right? So you have to go by inspection method. So as we had discussed the last class, again, I'll repeat the question once again over here because it is hidden. So let's say I want to solve this anyhow. If you turn back to your previous class notes, this question was actually solved. So we take x square, y square common. So it becomes dy by y square. Now I think you will recall this. Okay. And if you take x square, y cube common, it becomes 1 by y minus 1 by x dy equal to 0. Okay. Let's say you divide throughout with x square, y square. So it becomes dy by y square minus dx by x square. And this will become y 1 by y minus 1 by x dy. Okay. So you divide by, so this is nothing but negative differential of 1 by y minus 1 by x. Okay. Divide throughout with 1 by y minus 1 by x. So this term will come down. Okay. And this is nothing but negative ln 1 by y minus 1 by x plus y square by 2 equal to a constant. correct? Okay. So this question was a case where you could actually not use the formula directly, but it is a case of reducible to exact differential. Okay, so this term was actually d of this term. So basically you're ending up solving this. Am I right? Yes or no? But we could not figure this out. It was because probably there were inclusion and exclusion of certain terms from here. You dropped certain terms out of here. You could not rearrange it as was required by the formula. Right? Here your M and N were corrupted. Because see, ultimately what you did, you dropped this term, right? Did you see that you dropped X square, Y square term? This term, it was unnecessarily included in your M and N, and because of that, your dou M by dou Y equal to dou N by dou X condition got distorted. Right? So you were not able to identify that it was actually a case of exact differential equation because your M and N functions got corrupted. Are you getting my point here? So there only inspection can save you. Formula will fail. So where I corrupt your M and N, your formula is going to fail. Is my explanation understood by all of you?
Okay. Yes, sir.
So if the formula works, you are lucky. Go ahead, apply the, sorry. If the condition works, dou M by dou Y equal to dou N by dou X works, you are lucky. You can apply your formula and get your job done. If it doesn't work, then unfortunately, you have to rely on your problem solving instincts to get the question done. Okay. So with this, I'm going to something which we call as higher order derivatives, but sorry, higher degree derivatives, but still limited to the first order. Now, this is something which is not a very, very important concept from JE main point of view, but you never know, in JE advanced, they can give you as a comprehension. So now we are going to talk about